I was asked if I had instructions on how to create your own countdown timer. Now, this question was for a 45-minute timer with your own music. Now, I have made my timers on Canva, and I'll show you why it's so nice to do it that way. But Canva does have some limitations. First off, the longest the video can be is 60 minutes, but that's still okay for a 45-minute timer. But also, Canva has a limit to how many slides you can have in a presentation. So what we'll have to do here is create multiple different countdown timers in the way I'm going to show you, and then you can just add those videos together to create a timer that equals 45 minutes. You're going to need a couple of things. You're going to need a Google Sheet to get started, and then we can have our Canva account. If you don't have a Canva account yet, if you're a teacher, you can get a free Pro account. If you don't have a Pro account, there's still great things to do just with the free version. So let's go ahead and get started with our Google Sheet. I just opened up this Google Sheet by quickly just typing in sheets.new right here in the web address bar. And I'm gonna go ahead and just do this as timer. I'm gonna start with a 2-minute timer. So I'm gonna put in 2 in my first cell. I'm just gonna type in 2:00, and on the next one, 1:59. And so there I have a pattern started. And now I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna highlight both of these. So all I did was press shift and then I clicked on both. And now I'm gonna drag this down where that round circle is. I'm gonna hover over with my left click and I'm just gonna bring it down until it says 0. The great thing with Google Sheets is that Google Sheets will autofill for you. If it sees the pattern, it will just keep on going down. You can do things like that with the months of the year, the days of the week, counting with numbers. It does it great for you. All right, so there we are. We have it all the way down to 0. Now what I want to do is I'm going to save this as a CSV. So it's comma separated values is what CSV stands for. So we're going to go to File, Download, and I'm going to choose it as CSV. Click that right there and press Save. So now I have every second that I need to include in my timer, and I have it right here. Okay, now I'm going to go to my Canva account. I'm gonna go right here and just click video, and then I just want a landscape video, and I'm here. If you wanna do another size video, you can do that, but let me show you how you're going to start. Now you're just going to create your timer. I don't know what type of timer you want for the background. It's up to you what you want. I'm gonna do something very simple. I'm just gonna keep mine white, and I'm gonna insert my text. So you design the timer how you want. I'm gonna go ahead and put in my text. I want my time to be rather large, and I can come in, adjust the size, everything that I want. Now, the very great thing that Canva can do for us is that if you come over here on the left-hand side, you can scroll down and you can look for apps. Now, I already have the app I'm looking for. It's called Bulk Create, but if you don't have that one, just go to apps and right here and then search for Bulk Create, and then it will pop up. You could either upload your data right here, and we can go to our timer. I know I just named that. I'm gonna open, and there is my timer right there. So I'm gonna click on this. And so since I have that right here, I'm gonna right click on where it says title, and I'm going to connect data. And when I do that, it's going to be searching for that field, which is the 2 minutes, all right? And now I'm going to press continue. Now I'm gonna have a slide that has each of those times on there. So I'm gonna generate 120 slides. Well, it doesn't create the first one, so all I'm gonna do is click this very first one. I'm gonna click on it and right click and press duplicate, and then I'm gonna turn this one into 2 minutes. Now the next thing I want to do is we need to make sure that each slide is only 1 second long. So right up here at the top, I'm going to press edit timing, and I'm just going to go press 1 and apply to all pages. And you can see that I have that there. And then I'm going to press play so you can just see how it goes. And there is my timer right there. Now again, that's only a 2-minute timer. And you saw that was a lot of slides in that presentation. So now, if you want to add music, here's something you need to consider. It really depends on where you're going to put and house this timer. It's a video. It does take up space, especially if you have a 45-minute video. So you have to think about that. Where do you want to house it? Do you want to house it on something like YouTube? And then you can access it from anywhere. If you're housing it in your Google Drive account, remember, it's going to hold a lot of space. So that's something to think about. Now, if you put it on YouTube, you have to be very careful about your copyright. So you need to make sure you have music that doesn't have that copyright on there. Or if you do have music and you have permission, that you also make sure you cite it carefully. So that's really important. Now, let me show you a couple of things that you can do. You can Google for royalty-free music, and then you can find the music that you like. But if you have a YouTube account, which you should if you have a Google account, then when you go to your YouTube, my YouTube channel, on the side I can scroll down and I can go more from YouTube, and I can go to YouTube Studio. And when I click on that, I'm going to scroll down to where it says Audio Library. And then on the Audio Library, there is a lot of music that you, and just sounds and all sorts of things that you can use that is included with your YouTube account. Now, do make sure you click on the license type, because some of them, no attribution is required, so that's great. But you can also search for the moods. If you click right here, you can be looking for the type of mood that you want. Do you want it to be calm? And then you can press apply, and then you can search right here even by duration if you want to, and then you can start clicking ahead. So look at all of these. So you're not going to find any that really are 45 minutes long completely, but you could put some different music together. So I found something that I want to use. I'm going to use this Eighth World Wonder, and I'm even going to look here, and it says no attribution is required. That's great. And then I'm going to download that. So once I download that, I'm going to press save. And now that I have that saved, I can go back to Canva, and I can go over here on the left where I am looking for uploads. And if it's uploads, and then I'm going to take my upload and just drag it in. And you can see that it has come right here. So now the next thing I want to do is I want to just drag this over into down here. And let's put it below it like that. And now my timer has music. Now that you have all of the numbers that you need and you also have the music, we're gonna go to that very last slide right here. This is where you would put in your last page. So you can come back over here to elements, put a clock, and you can find an alarm clock that's in there. I'm gonna use this one, okay? And it already plays. I'm gonna make sure it's centered so I can press position and then make sure it's in the middle and it is centered. And I also want to add music to a sound to that. So I can go back to my audio library and I can click up here and look at sound effects for that. So now I've found that alarm clock and I'm just gonna press download and save. And then I'm also going to put that right in here into my uploads. So I'm going to click over here for uploads, go over here, alarm clock, and then I want to put that alarm clock sound right on top of that last one. And so now when I play this, it will be playing and I don't have my sound on. That is how you are able to put that timer on. Now, for your question about the 45-minute timer, let me show you what you would have to do to make the 45-minute timer. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to go and I'm going to go to share, and I'm going to go to download, and I'm going to download this 2-minute timer. It's going to download onto my computer. Now, once it downloads onto my computer, then I'm going to upload it back into Canva. And then you would make your next one. Now, you don't have to make these as 2-minute timers. I think you can probably get I've done a 10-minute timer, but definitely an 8-minute timer. You can have time for that one. So you make sure that you're just creating timers that are 8 minutes at a time and just adjust those numbers. Then I'm going to show you how you can put them all back together. So 2-minute timer. All right. So now I have that over there. I'm going to bring this back in. And I'm going to upload that into my video uploads. So now I'm going to show you how you can actually put multiple videos together into one. So what you would do is you would go back to video, and this is assuming that you have created all of your smaller timer videos. You're going to go back to video just like we did before, and you're going to make another video. And then what you will do is you're going to go to your uploads. And then go to videos, and these are all of the videos that you have made before. So you can see I'm just going to put in this one, and that is my 2-minute timer. And then I can also add another video right in there. And so if you look, I have all these videos that are together, and then you would just keep adding your videos all the way there. Now, it might be something that you don't want to put in music until the very end, and you have created all of your timer videos, and then you put the music in at the very end when on your final video. But I believe I've given you all the elements and all of the tools that you'll need to create something, and I hope this is helpful. If you need help knowing how to upload it to YouTube or wherever you're going to post it, just let me know. But I do hope this is helpful, and if you have any questions, please just let me know.